Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvenni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. This is lecture number 1.9 in the Linear Programming Problem, LPP. And the topic for this lecture is Duality in Linear Programming Problem, and we will solve problem in the duality. The learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to convert the primal problem into dual problem. So, in the earlier lecture, we discussed the linear programming problem. We solved the LPP using graphical method, simplex method, Big M method, two-phase method. So, these are all the four methods we use to find the solution for linear programming problem based on the condition. If it is two variable problem, we can use the graphical method. If there are more than two variables, we have to use the simplex method or Big M method or two phase method depending on the constraint equation. And another method to solve the problem is converting the linear programming problem into dual problem. Then we solve the problem by dual simplex method. That is what we are going to discuss in this lecture. So, duality in linear programming problem. The given LPP, linear programming problem, can also be expressed by reversing the row and column of the algebraic statements of the problem. When you reverse the conventional LPP, we write the conventional LPP with objective equation, the constraint equation. When you reverse the row and the column, the new type of problem is called as dual problem. The solution of the dual problem can be obtained in the same way as the primal problem using the simplex method, and this is called as dual simplex method. So, dual simplex method, it will have its own specific features. When we are not able to solve the problem by simplex method because of the constraints, we go to the either Big M method or two phase method. But still, if it is difficult to solve, it is not possible to solve by the two method, then we are going to use the dual simplex method. So, for dual simplex method, first we have to convert the primal problem into dual problem, then we have to apply the simplex method in the dual simplex method. So, this is the linear programming problem, LPP, in the mathematical form. We take maximize z equal to c1 x1 plus c2 x2 plus c3 x3 up to cn xn, where c1, c2, c3 are the cost coefficient, x1, x2, x3 and xn, they are the decision variables, and we have the constraints a11 x1 plus a12 x2 plus a13 x3, which is less than or equal to b1. Similarly, a21 x1 plus a22 x2, a23 x3 less than or equal to b2, and a31 x1 plus a32 x2 plus a33 x3 less than or equal to b3, and we have am1 x1 plus am2 x2 plus am3 x3 is less than or equal to bm, and the decision variables x1 to xn, all the values are greater than or equal to 0, non-negative condition, and the above LPP problem is called as primal problem. So, in this lecture, we try to understand how to convert the primal problem into dual problem. So, the maximization type of problem, we are going to convert into dual problem. So, we designate the objective equation. So, the objective equation, first equation, we take the variable y1, second equation, we take the variable y2, third equation, we take the variable y3, and the final equation, we take the variable ym. Now, the equation, how to write the equation? The objective equation, when you have maximization type of problem in the LPP, the dual problem will become minimization type of problem. So, in that case, so the dual problem will be like this. Minimize w equal to b1 y1 plus b2 y2 plus b3 y3 up to bm ym. So, look at here b1 y1 plus b2 y2 plus b3 y3 plus BMYM, that is what the equation, W equal to, we outright, this is minimization. Now, the constant equation, A11Y1, A21Y2, A31Y3, AM1YM, which is greater than or equal to C1. So, look at here, A11Y1 plus A21Y2 plus A31Y3 greater than or equal to C1. When the constant equation is less than or equal to type in the LPP, primal problem, in the dual problem, the constant will become greater than or equal to. So, the cost coefficient, the objective equation will become the constant, the value of the constant equation on the right side. So, similarly, A12Y1 plus A22Y2 plus A32Y3 up to, this is greater than or equal to C2. A13Y1 plus A23Y2 plus A33Y3, which is greater than or equal to C3. And finally, A1NY1 plus A2NY2 plus A3NY3, which is greater than or equal to CM. Here, Y1, Y2, Y3 up to YM, they are greater than or equal to 0. This is the non-negative condition of the variable. So, this is the dual of the problem. So, there are certain conditions, certain theorem for converting primal problem into dual problem that we will discuss later. So, before that, the relationship for the primal and the dual. If primal contains n variables and m constraints, the dual will have m variables and n constraints. So, converting row into column, so the reverse will take place. When you have n variable, now it becomes n constraint in the dual. When you have m constraint, it will become m variables in the dual. The maximization type, maximization problem in the primal becomes minimization problem in the dual. The maximization problem contains less than or equal to constraints, while minimization problem will contains greater than or equal to constraints. The coefficient of variable in the objective function of primal will appear in the right hand side of the dual constraints. The constant appear on the right hand side of the primal will appear on the objective function of the dual. The variable in both the problem are non-negative. So, these are all the relationship between primal and the dual. Now, we take one example. So, construct the dual to the primal problem. So, maximize z equal to 5x1 plus 8x2 subject to 2x1 plus 5x2 less than or equal to 45, 8x1 plus 5x2 less than or equal to 80, 3x1 minus x2 less than or equal to 5, 4x1 plus 2x2 less than or equal to 15. So, it is maximization type of problem. All the constraints we have less than or equal to symbol. Now, we convert. First, we designate. First constraint as y1, second constraint as y2, third constraint as y3, fourth constraint as y4. Now, we write the equation. Maximize 45y1 plus 80y2 plus 5y3 plus 15y4. Minimize W equal to 45y1, 80y2, 5y3, 15y4, which is the minimization type of problem, objective equation, subject to the constraints. Now, we have only two variables here and four constraints. Now, in the dual, there will be only two constraints with the four variables. Listen here, 2y1 plus 8y2 plus 3y3 plus 4y4 greater than or equal to 5. So, 2y1 plus 8y2 plus 3y3 plus 4y4 greater than or equal to 5, and 5y1, 5y2 minus y3 plus 2y4 greater than or equal to 8. So, 5y1 plus 5y2 minus y3 plus 2y4 greater than or equal to 8, and y1, y2, y3, y4, they are greater than or equal to 0. So, for the primal problem, this is the corresponding dual problem. So, this we can solve. We have only two constraints. We can comfortably solve. Here we have four constraints. We have to go more iteration. Here it is very easy to solve the problem. Now, we take another example. Write the dual of the problem. Minimize z equal to 2x1 plus 5x2 and subject to the constraint x1 plus 2x2 greater than or equal to 4, 3x1 plus 4x2 greater than or equal to 7, x1 plus x2 less than or equal to 8, and x1, x2, the equations, the decision variables are greater than or equal to 0. Now, it is minimization type of problem. All the constraints should be greater than or equal to type. But the third constraint is less than or equal to type. So minimization the problem, the constraint should be greater than or equal to type. Multiply the third constraint by the negative sign, the constraint will become minus x1 minus x2 greater than or equal to minus 8. Now the problem is modified like this. Z equal to minimize z equal to 2x1 plus 5x2 subject to x1 plus 2x2 greater than or equal to 4, 3x1 plus 4x2 greater than or equal to 7, minus x1 minus x2 greater than or equal to minus 8, and x1 x2 values are greater than or equal to 0. Now this is the primal problem, minimization type of primal problem with constraint equation greater than or equal to type. Now we designate first equation as y1, second equation as y2, and third equation as y3. Now we write the dual problem. So here it is minimization type of problem. In the dual, it will become maximization type. So maximize W equal to 4y1 plus 7y2 minus 8y3. Subject to, there are three constraint equation, two variables. Now we will have two constraint equation with the three variables. So y1 plus 3y2 minus y3 less than or equal to 2, and 2y1 plus 4y2 minus y3 less than or equal to 5. So y1, y2, y3 values are greater than or equal to 0. This is the non-negative condition of the variable. So converting minimization type of problem into dual, it will become maximization type of problem. We take another example, construct the dual of the problem, maximize z equal to x1 plus 2x2 plus 3x3 subject to the constraint minus 6x1 plus x2 minus x3 less than or equal to 5 minus x1 minus 2x1 plus 2x2 minus 3x3 greater than or equal to 3, 2x1 minus 4x3 equal to 1. So it is maximization type of problem. So for maximization type of problem, all the constraint equations should be greater than or equal to type. So sorry, less than or equal to type. So first constraint is all right. So multiply the second constraint by minus sign. So it will become minus 2x1 minus 2x2 plus 3x3 less than or equal to minus 3. And the third constraint can be split into two inequalities. So 2x1 minus 4x3 less than or equal to 1. 2x1 minus 4x3 greater than or equal to 1. And this equation we have to multiply by minus 1. So minus 2x1 plus 4x3 less than or equal to minus 1. Now we will get four constraints. So the maximize z equal to x1 plus 2x2 plus 3x3. First constraint as it is. Second constraint multiplied by negative sign. Third constraint is split into 2. And these are all the four constraint equations for the maximization type of problem. Now we designate the constraint equation as y1, y2, y3, y4. Now we write the dual of the problem. So W equal to 5y1 minus 3y2 plus y3 minus y4. So we take y3 dash and y3 2 dash, because we have combined, we have split the two constraint equation, we write 2 of y3 dash minus y3 double dash greater than or equal to 1. So because 2 values here, right? Then second constraint y1 minus 2y2 greater than or equal to 2. Greater than or equal to 2. Because the third constraint there is no x2 value. Y1 minus 2y2 greater than or equal to 2. And third constraint equation minus y1 plus 3y2 minus 4 into y3 dash minus y3 double dash. So this is y3 dash and y3 double dash is greater than or equal to 3. So the y3 is y3 dash, y4 equal to y3 double dash. So this is the dual problem of the primal problem given in the example. So the duality theorem, we have certain theorem. First theorem, theorem 1, the dual of the dual is primal. So we are converting primal into dual. When you write the dual of the dual, it will become primal. Theorem number 2, the value of the objective function in the z for any feasible solution of the primal is less than or equal to the value of the objective function W for any feasible solution of the dual. So, value of the objective function is less than or equal to value of the objective function W for any feasible solution. Theorem number 3. If either of the primal or the dual problem has unbound solution, the solution to the other problem is infeasible. When you have unbound solution, the solution for both the primal and dual will be infeasible. Theorem number 4. If both the primal and the dual problem have the feasible solution, then both have optimal solution and the maximum z equal to minimum w. So, the objective equation, the maximum of z is the primal problem, minimum of w, it is a dual problem, solution for the dual problem. And fifth theorem, it states that if the primal variable is positive, then the corresponding dual constant is an equation at the optimum. If the primal constant is strict inequality, then the corresponding dual variable is 0 at the optimum. If the dual variable is positive, then the corresponding primal constant is an equation at the optimum. If the dual constant is a strict inequality, then the corresponding primal variable is 0 at the optimum. So, these are all the theorem 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, in the next lecture, we solve problems using the dual simplex method. And these are all the books I have published in mechanical engineering subject. You may find operation research book, which will be useful for your further reading. I upload the video lectures of all the mechanical engineering subjects listed here in the YouTube channel. You subscribe to the channel. Use the video lectures for your better learning. So, thanks for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can write to my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again in the next lecture to solve few problems in the dual simplex method. Until then, bye.